morning, good morning. So you see him in the back too. She's back asleep. Birthday girl. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning. Welcome to another Ernest Bill West broadcast. I just want to just show you what I do behind the scenes and what I do pretty much every day. We go pretty much twice a week. We go to therapy twice a week, early in the morning, fighting through traffic. But I'm grateful. My son is standing. He's walking. He's getting stronger every day. And so I'm just thankful for that. What I do want to do today, and I'm not going to be long because I don't have much time, because we're almost at our destination. But this is a new month. This is a new month, and it's a new month of new beginnings. And I come to tell you today that this is the hour of your new beginning. God wants to give you a new beginning. The Bible says that if any man is in Christ Jesus, old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. God wants to give you a new encounter with Him. God wants to give you a new awareness of life. God wants to give you a new joy, a new wisdom. And what I want to also let you know also, this is also, like I said, an hour in the season of miracles. A miracle is something new. A miracle is a blessing. A miracle is a gift. A miracle is a supernatural ability. It's a supernatural blessing, gift from God. And in this hour, in this season, God wants to give you a supernatural gift. He wants to give you a supernatural blessing from Him. And what I want to tell you today, God let me know this the other day, and He let me know that your miracle is in your closet. Your miracle, what you've been praying for, what you've been asking God to give you, is in the closet. It's in your closet, and that closet is prayer. That's where it's at. It's in your prayer. You've been asking God for direction. God said your answer is in prayer. Your answer. Now check this out. In Matthew 6:6, it says that the Bible says that concerning prayer, it said that when you pray, go into your closet. And the moment that you get into your closet, close the door. And see, God wants you to get into a secret place. He wants you to get into a closet. See, A.A. Allen got into that closet. He got into a closet, and he didn't get out until God blessed him with the gift of healing. And so you need to hold on to your blessing, and you need to get in that closet and hold on and stay there until God gives you direction, until God gives you your blessing. Just like with Jacob wrestled with that angel, and he was not going to let that angel go until he got something. And so you have to be at that place right now where you hold on to your promise, you hold on to what God has told you until it happens. And see, the thing about it, if it is pain, sometimes it's pain, hold on to that pain, because in that pain, in that pressure place, in that uncomfortable place, that's where your miracle is. See, a lot of times people let go of their miracle. They give up on their miracle before it's matured, before it's birthed out. Don't let it die. Let it birth. And so today, I just want to let you know that your blessing, your miracle is in your closet. And so God is commanding, I'm commanding you to go to your closet and find your answer. Go to your closet and find your breakthrough. Go to your closet and hear from God, because in that closet also is obedience. There's a greater obedience that God wants to give to you. God said, the Bible said, obedience is better than sacrifice. There are many things that escape us is simply because we didn't obey. Simply God just wants to give it to us. The Bible says that obedience is better than sacrifice. See, when you have to sacrifice something, it's you using your hands. You're using your hand, but God don't want you to have to sacrifice in order to get this blessing. God wants you to be obedient. That's your sacrifice, your obedience. Your sacrifice is your time. God wants your time. God wants your time and your presence. Your time and your presence. And He's calling you to your closet. He's calling you to your secret place. That's where your answer is at. Your answer is in your secret place. You have a marital problem. You have a relationship problem. Where your answer is in your secret place, that secret place would mean to stand still. Stand still and lock in to prayer, fasting, and seek God's face. Seek Him. Seek Him. Not, don't seek your mind, because the Bible tells us to trust in Him in all our ways. Acknowledge Him first. Acknowledge Him first, and He will direct our path. And so in our acknowledgement, that closet is seeking God first. Going to that closet is obedience. Going to that closet is doing the will of God, doing what you know God has called you to do. And see, many of you, there are gifts that are in you. But through the course of time, you laid those gifts down, or you forgot, or the cares of this life, and you forgot your gift. You're not using your gift no more. God wants you to get that gift back. God wants you to pick your gift back up. And that gift is in your closet. Your closet of prayer. God wants to give you a new encounter with Him. God wants to liberate you from what you're facing. God wants to liberate you from what you're dealing with. But the only way He can separate you is that you must obey. And that's to separate, to cut. Also, this is a separation. This is a separate season. This is a season of separation. Because anytime there's a harvest, there's a separation between tares and wheat. And see, what God is doing, God is weeding out the tares out of your life. God is weeding out hate out of your life. God is weeding out negative people out of your life. God is weeding those things out that you might receive your miracle. See, because your miracle is for you and you and you and you only. And God don't want you to share this particular miracle. God wants you to be blessed and receive this miracle. And once you become blessed and receive this miracle, God wants you to become a blessing, become a miracle, a birth seeds of a miracle in other people's lives. Hear me and hear me well. This is your hour. This is your season of blessing. This is your season of breakthrough. This is your season of a new beginning. And also, let me explain something to you. The Bible says that in your wilderness place, God's going to cause a river to spring up. And so many of you, you're in a dry place. You're in a dry place of pain, discouragement, hurt. It feels like so that God has forgotten you. It feels like God has hidden Himself for you. You're in a dry place. See, but in this dry place, God has been hiding Himself, or it seems like He's been hiding Himself, because He's stretching your faith. He's maturing your faith. He's building up your faith. He's making your faith become full, where you get to a place where you can only depend and trust in Him. That's where God wants you at. God don't want you to trust in your own ability. He don't want you to trust in people. He don't want you to trust in man. But God wants you to totally and completely trust in Him. The command that God is giving His people, it is said that he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And what God is doing, God is commanding, and God is calling His people into His secret chamber. And in His secret chamber, God wants to change you. God wants to give you a new encounter with Him. God wants to give you even a greater power. See, God wants to give you and teach you how and birth out of you miracles. That's why He's stretching your faith, because your faith is connected to miracles. God wants to use you in His kingdom that His power might be manifest in this earth. See, God wants willing vessels. Are you willing? Are you willing to be blessed? Are you willing to be used by God? And if you're willing to be used by God, then God wants you to get to the closet. See, because in the closet, and some of you are already in the closet, and that closet is pressure. That closet is pain, discomfort, troubles, all those things. And see, the thing about it, that's wisdom. See, because that's wisdom being birthed, because Solomon said, in wisdom there's much sorrow, and in knowledge there's much grief. And so what you're going through, the sorrow, the grief, and all of that, is birthing wisdom out of you. God has given you a new language, and God has given you a new tongue. And in this tongue, God is giving you flavor. He's giving you wisdom. And in this wisdom, God is going to teach you how to speak according to His mind. God's going to give you the wisdom on how to unlock many people's doors, prison doors in their life. So be obedient and be willing and be available. See, because God is looking for someone who's available to be used in His kingdom. Amen. God bless you. Go to the closet. That's where your miracle's at. God bless you.